morning, everyone. Today, my goal is to change the rear shocks on my 2012 Nissan Titan Pro 4X. Also, why we're gonna take the wheels off, we're gonna change the rotors. So I'm upgrading the old one with the new Bilstein 5100. Yeah, that's what they call it. There you go. This is the shock that it's gonna go in. We're not gonna cut this one first. We're gonna cut this after we install them. And it's not working. More sun. So this is what I have. I think they call them a Rancho. As you can see, this is kind of bent right here, and we got two bolts only. Most of the people said that you can do it without taking the wheels off. Yeah, you might get more dirty than taking the wheel off. So it's pretty easy to take the wheels off, so I don't see why I wouldn't. Okay, so down here we have a 19, I believe. Yes, a 19 millimeter socket. Here, you may need an extension. Let's see, can I put an adapter? So I break it loose with my bar 19, and now it should work. And this bolt is here since the tripod. Jesus. Oh my gosh, chainsaw. This is what I have. I believe this is longer and it's gonna stay a little bit longer in the back. But we'll see. I like how it looks like. And based on the reviews, based on a bunch of people on the YouTube, I don't think I'm doing something wrong, so let's see. As you can see, there's no way you can put this one with the suspension on the jack. So what we're gonna do, since we're here, we're gonna change this roller, because we already changed the front ones with the drilled and slotted. And yeah, after we install this roller, we're gonna put the wheel on. I'm gonna put the car on the ground. So we got here. I'm gonna take this gray caliper. Oh, what we got here? I believe it's a 10 millimeter bolt that holds this one. So this is the old one, so I guess we gotta with the hammer, or maybe no. Let's see. Let's compare this old one with the new one. I thought this hole is gonna be all the way through, but they're not. So yeah, let's clean up a little bit here, and we gonna change the roller. Yep, gotta take a brake cleaner and wire brush, and we're gonna clean the surface a little bit so it doesn't get bad in the future. Alright. Even if it's gravel on the ground, I don't want to do too much mess, so I always like to be on the clean side. Small brush, big brush, brush, you put it on a drill, doesn't matter which one. It both works, so take your time. It'd be easy for you if you clean everything and loop everything on, be easy for the future, change the brakes. So also what I like to do is what's it called? Copper anti-seize brake lube made by 3M. I always use this one on metal to metal. I hope you can see something. Yep, let's clean the rotor inside. The brand new rollers has like a grease on it, like a surface protection, something on. There you go. Okay, so we're gonna clean the outside part and we're gonna compress the piston. Let's see. This is kind of what I do on my day off when I'm not working, which I like, can't complain. Just like that. Okay, so for the brake caliper, we are going to take this brake out. Okay, hey guys, just wear gloves. It's gonna be easy, it won't hurt you, so This is what I have. It's kind of small, old, but it does the trick. I don't need a performance one, so I don't do brakes all the time. So I should be okay with this. Just leave the brake pad where the piston is. And just put this in the middle. Just like that. And tie it down. You see the piston goes in. That's it. There you go. Just slide in. Now let's see what we did. So actually this rubber boot was holding out the brake caliper on there. That's it, I should be fine. Don't get nowhere. Yep, right now let's put the wheel on and let's finish with the truck. Not too tight, because anyway I'm gonna torque them down to, as you guys can see, a little bit more we're gonna lift from the cab and it's gonna be good. There you go.
I tighten down to torque specification. And we're gonna move to the next one. I'm not gonna show you guys how to do the next one because it's pretty much the same. I believe on that side you have to take a plastic cover off. Here, where is this bolt? Up here, and there's a plastic cover here for the frame, like on this side. So you may want to take it off, and then you can reach the bolt. All right, let's do that side too. So behind this plastic, you need a Phillips screwdriver. Take out this one, and this one no, it's a no. And there's something flip inside here. Take it off, and you're gonna have access to the bolt for the shock. All right, I'm just gonna do it quickly, and I'll catch you guys in the end. So as I said, you're gonna have a Phillips screwdriver here, a Phillips screwdriver here on the bottom, and you're gonna have this clip, plastic clip, rivet, whatever it calls, right here behind the fender flares. Yeah, and after that, everything is exposed. I would say you have more room on this side than on the other one. So, we'll see. Maybe I'll use my gun, the DeWalt. This is what I have. It's very powerful. So, yeah, pretty much this is like the same on the other side. Let's do it.